So it's about time that I finally make my Smash Ultimate DLC wishlist video. I did one of these for the base roster of Smash Ultimate during the pre-release hype, and so you know I had to do it to them for the DLC fighters as well. Basically, I'm going to be talking about 4 slots worth of characters because the 5th is obviously taken up by the recently released Joker, who we knew about since the day the game came out. Just a side note, I really wish that they would just tell us the day a character is coming out, rather than string us along and then drop the character randomly. They did it that way for both Plant and now for Joker, and so I hope in the future, for the next 4, they just say a date and then release him that day. Don't just drop it with a surprise for us the next day, you know? I really don't like that. Alright, but enough of that, let's talk characters. So the first character I want to see is Banjo and Kazooie, and this is my absolute number 1 pick. Banjo-Kazooie and Chewie are probably my favorite N64 games. I love their take on the platforming genre, they've got a really unique sense of humor, and their art style is top-notch. When Smash 4 was announced, I was dying for Banjo-Kazooie to be in the game. And then again, I was dying for them when DLC for Smash 4 was announced. Then with Ultimate, I was in the same camp yet again, and now here I am talking about it in a DLC wishlist video, so it has been years. I'm literally older from the point that I've wanted Banjo and Kazooie in the game versus now where they still aren't in the game. I've just been so patient that I just really hope it comes true. I know my personal patience doesn't play any kind of a role in the actual addition of a character, but I just want him so bad. As an actual fighter, they have such a wide variety of options for their moveset, between the different combat moves that they have to the different eggs that they can pick up and use, and even the dozen or so transformations that they have throughout all of their games. I'd also be really interested in how their art style would be handled, since the only modern appearance they have is in Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. And that art is just not great. Microsoft did something weird with their designs. They were trying to like give it its own quirkiness, even though it already had its own quirkiness. It was really, really like a weird take on Banjo and Kazooie. So I'd be really interested to see how a modern Banjo-Kazooie design would be done for Smash. I'm sure that they would take a lot of their liberties, but if the focus was on their N64 designs, then I think that the Smash team could really make them look good for the game. Even if as a character they were super, super campy, I would play the hell out of them because I've wanted to be able to do so for years. But since Banjo is owned by Microsoft, my biggest fear is obviously that Steve from Minecraft is going to be the rep that they choose. Personally, I could see it going either way, honestly. If Nintendo approaches Microsoft and says that they want a character in Smash, it would make the most sense for them to choose one that's an icon from the Nintendo 64 era that was on their own console. But on Microsoft's end, it makes sense for them to ask for a character to be in Smash that's a part of one of their actively popular properties. Unless they're planning for some kind of Banjo-Kazooie content to be released in the near future, it makes the most sense for them, from a business standpoint, to ask for Steve in the game. Now, objectively, I think that I would be alright with Steve in the game. Like, if he got in, I'd be cool with it, I wouldn't really be mad. It's just that Steve being in means that Banjo most likely has to be out, and so I would just be so devastated. In a perfect world, we could get both, but I know in my heart of hearts that Steve is more likely, and if Steve is added, that means that Banjo just simply cannot be added either. Side note, Master Chief always gets added to these topics when it's talking about a Microsoft rep in Smash, and I honestly wouldn't be too sad if Master Chief replaced Banjo. I mean, I would be sad Banjo wasn't in, but I think Master Chief is such a cool character that I would be alright with it too. So if I had to stack rank them, it would be Banjo-Kazooie, then Master Chief, then a big power gap, and then Steve. So anyone who shows up to my streams whenever I do stream knows that I am constantly asked which characters I want for Smash DLC. And I always say that number 1 is Banjo, and number 2 is Sora. I love Kingdom Hearts, and I've loved it for so long, and just like Banjo-Kazooie, I'd love to see Sora represented in that game. There's such a rich variety of movement and attack options that he could really be fleshed out into a fantastic character. Despite the story grimaces that many fans have with the game, and some less than stellar other parts, the gameplay of Kingdom Hearts is the most consistently good part of the series, except for when you have to play Yu-Gi-Oh! To use your attacks. With some tweaking, that could apply really well to Smash. Obviously, we can't have Sora hanging around in the air for 10 seconds at a time like he does in his home series, but having different aerial combos combined with magic would just be amazing. And the Disney issue really doesn't feel like an issue to me if we just don't include Mickey, Donald, and Goofy. Full-on Disney characters don't have to be present to have Sora in the game. And while he's technically a Disney IP, he's definitely in a different tier than Donald and Goofy. And on top of that, he's a joint property between Disney and Square Enix. And so if we are to believe the rumors that Square will have a new character, there's definitely a chance of Sora being that character. I mean, Disney licensed this mess to be sold in stores. If they're willing to turn their own mascot, as well as Sora, into some weird Roblox-looking pile of crap, Sora in Smash is practically a shoe-in. Unfortunately, some of the leakers have heard differently. Apparently, there is a high chance of seeing Erdrick or some other Dragon Quest rep added into Smash, and this is really only strengthened by Dragon Quest XI S coming to Switch later this year. Now, I'm not a huge Dragon Quest fan, and while I'd be sad for Sora not to be added, I think that Erdrick would be a neat character based on what little I do know of the Dragon Quest franchise. If I had to pick, it would be Sora, but I don't think I'd be mad for a Dragon Quest rep. As for Geno, I think all hope is lost for my boy. I'd love to see him in the game, and I don't believe that him as a spirit means that he can't be in the game as a fighter, but I just don't think that he is going to be a fighter. As much as Sakurai likes him, as much as he has sort of a cult following as a character and potential fighter in Smash, I just worry that he isn't notable enough to be added. Several characters already were added to Smash because of the ballot, specifically Ridley, King K. Rool, and the Belmonts. My fear is that there are too many of these black sheep characters who were voted in from the ballot, and that means that future characters in a similar category couldn't be added. Now, obviously, Sakurai plays by his own rules. What he says goes, and if it came down to it and he wanted to add Geno, Banjo, Steve, Master Chief, and Cooking Mama, those are the characters that we would see. But I think there's going to be a balance between old and new characters added, and for Geno, I just worry that he's going to miss the cut. But we can't get all third-party reps. Even excluding the veterans that were DLC for Smash 4, we still had one of the four DLC newcomers coming from a Nintendo franchise, and that of course was Corrin. So I wouldn't be surprised if a similar ratio was done for Ultimate's DLC as well. Especially with Nintendo allegedly being a big factor in the pool of characters for Sakurai to choose from, it wouldn't surprise me at all if they requested one first-party fighter alongside all the others. And they have a decent pool of characters that they can still add, and a couple of them are incredibly obvious. The first is Rex from Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Rex was offered as a Mii Sword Fighter skin for anyone who purchased the Fighter Pass, and during that segment they mentioned that certain characters didn't make the cut for the base roster because of the way the development phase lined up. They picked the characters at the very beginning of the planning phase, and once they decided the roster, they don't change it, regardless of if new games or characters come out and they would work in Smash. And of course that makes sense. If they kept adding characters to the hypothetical roster based on new stuff coming out, the game would just get delayed more and more and more, and then it would probably never come out because there would always be a new cool character that could be added to Smash. But the DLC wasn't chosen until after the full base game was released, so now they had ample time to choose characters that they couldn't during Ultimate's development, and Rex absolutely qualifies as one of those. Xenoblade is one of Nintendo's newer properties that is super popular, as evidenced by the fact that Rex as a Mii Fighter was chosen to be offered as the Fighter Pass bonus, so they clearly know that that is a character people would want. So I wouldn't be surprised at all if they added him as a fighter. On top of this, and you're about to hate me, but Fire Emblem Three Houses is coming out, and Sakurai loves him some Fire Emblem reps. Literally every Smash game since Melee has had at least one new Fire Emblem fighter, even if they're just a clone or Echo fighter. So grabbing a character from Three Houses and putting them in Smash would be pretty cool. And if they weren't just a swordsman, which I hope they wouldn't be, a magic user like Robin or something totally unique like Corrin would be awesome, and most people would probably be okay with it as far as the character's playstyle goes. There are obviously going to be people who are real life mad that another Fire Emblem rep would be added to the roster, but as long as it's a unique character playstyle wise, I would be totally on board. We just don't need another Marth, that's my stance on it. And lastly, I just have no idea. I'm stretched pretty thin with this list as it is, and honestly, I just don't know who else to pick. There are a bunch of characters I feel like I can say here, but whether they're likely is a totally different argument. I must say I am pretty surprised that we got Rathalos and a bunch of Monster Hunter references in game without getting some kind of fighter. So I think it'd be cool if something from that franchise was added. There are also characters like Travis Touchdown or Phoenix Wright, where the developers have a very good relationship with Nintendo, and at least for those two specifically, I think they would be really cool in Smash. I'd worry about Travis because he is kind of just another swordsman, but we'd have to just see. I'm sure Sakurai could do something cool. Crash or Spyro also come to mind, and I think that would be really neat to give us another old PS1 era rep, since the only one that I can really think of right now is Cloud. And especially given how they recently got their own HD remasters, I think that their popularity is at a high from where they were in recent years, which with Crash, he just kind of fell off and didn't really have any kind of content. And with Spyro, everyone's opinion of him was Skylanders. So I think both of them, given that they have HD remasters, would definitely be welcome in Smash. Though I would have to say that movesets for those two might be pretty difficult. Crash is pretty generic, he kinda just has jumping and spinning, and Spyro is a quadruped, and we don't really have very many of those in the game. I can think of Duck Hunt and Ivysaur, and really, that's it. So they would be pretty difficult to make a moveset for, but again, I trust Sakurai to make something cool if those were added. And man, I don't know, add Goku or Shrek or Waluigi or something. Yeah, I don't care. I just don't add Fortnite, man. That's all. Or, you know what, do it. I don't care. It'd be pretty funny. Just do it. I like to see some people get mad. But that is it for my list of characters that I think would be cool for Smash Ultimate DLC. I kind of went 50-50 when it came to this list. I talked about characters that I personally really want, but then I also talked about characters that I think are reasonable to get in, you know? So I had a kind of pragmatic stance for the other half of this video. Piranha Plant and Joker were both such out of left field picks. Piranha Plant, I would never have guessed in a million years. Joker, while I probably would have guessed him before Piranha Plant, I also didn't really expect him to be in the game because he just didn't really seem like he'd fit, or I didn't think the game series was popular enough. So really, honestly, I feel like anything can go with the DLC. We'll probably have one or two predictable characters, but I predict, honestly, that the only thing to predict is unpredictability. I don't know if that made sense. The only certainty that we can have is uncertainty. I guess that's a better way of saying it. But regardless, I would love to know what you guys think of my list in this video. Do you agree with anything I said? Do you disagree? What kind of characters do you want to see added to Smash 4 for DLC? I would always love hearing certain, you know, points of view, because I've seen a lot of Shantae, for example, and Shantae was never really a game I was interested in, so I personally don't want her, but I wouldn't, like, hate her if she got added. I'm always just curious about the different points of view of different players, because so many of us have different gaming backgrounds that, you know, I focus on one aspect or one section of games that I play, and there might not be overlap with another person, so I'd really be interested to hear what you guys have to say, what characters you want down in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you are new here, then be sure to subscribe. I will see you guys next time. Peace out, and I hope you have an awesome day.